Hey folks, Dr. Mike here for Renaissance Periodization, video number 2 in Fat Loss Dieting Made Simple, Choosing High Quality Foods. So last time, in the first video of the series, we essentially learned to track our macros to find out how much of proteins, carbs, and fats, and thus calories, we were actually eating, which is really good. And ideally, where we're going with this is we want to manipulate those macros, probably lowering the fats and carbs to some extent, keeping the protein high, in order to spare muscle, keep it on our bodies, and lose fat. That's definitely a thing, but we're not going to rush to that. We have one step at least to cover first, which is making sure that the composition of the food we're eating is at least better than usual, somewhat close to optimized, right? This means a couple of things. If we eat more of the right foods and fewer of the foods that aren't so great, we can do a couple of things. First, we can make sure that for the amount of macros we're getting, let's say 300 grams of carbs a day, we're getting the most nutrition value for it. The most vitamins, minerals, phytochemicals, fiber, so on and so forth. And if you eat like all of your carbs from pixie sticks, well, pixie sticks have sugar and just about nothing else. If you eat all of your carbs from healthier sources like fruits or whole grains, then you can get a ton of really good nutrition with it too. And in addition to that, especially with protein quality and sources and some of the fat stuff, the amount of muscle you can retain is higher if your quality of intake is higher. So not only is this good for health, but it's good for muscle retention. And health during a fat loss diet is a big deal because you're kind of impinging on the immune system. It's been shown that anytime you lower your calories for a prolonged period of time, your immune function's not as great. Of course, because you know the system operates on a certain amount of throughput, and if you constrain that throughput, the system doesn't operate as well. So being that you know people have more of a tendency to get sick when they're in fat loss diets, we want to make sure we're as healthy as possible, not just in general for the long term, which is good, but also to make sure that fat loss diet proceeds with as few bumps in the road as possible. In addition to that, choosing the right foods keeps our hunger levels lower. This is huge, huge. If you eat mostly junk food on a fat loss diet, you absolutely can lose fat and lose weight. However, junk food is so energy dense and so hyper palatable, means it's so delicious, that like if you eat a Twinkie, you're like, okay, I can eat 5 of those, no problem. But if you eat like 6 apples, which probably has about as many calories as a Twinkie, then you're like, wow, holy crap, I can't even finish these last 2. Same calories, and all of a sudden you have no problem getting full versus you're kind of hungry after. Big deal. And yeah, on paper the macros have very similar effects, but if some of the foods make you much less hungry than others, your chance of high degree of compliance on the diet is much better if you're not hungry. Like the number one reason people fall off the wagon with their plan is because they get hungry and they eat foods that are tasty. Right? But if you're already eating foods that don't really make you that hungry, you can have a pretty good caloric deficit, lose a lot of fat, no harm, no foul. Right? And lastly, a lot of these foods can allow you to have the experience of higher energy levels, right? And that's really good because in a fat loss diet, your energy is just not going to be that great anyway because you're at a hypocaloric condition, you're kind of impinged on the amount of energy you have anyway, and you tend to slow down. And not only is this annoying because you burn fewer calories when you slow down, but also like, you know, you have kids and work and school and all this other stuff, you would like to have as much energy as possible. And if you eat more of the right kinds of foods and fewer of the foods that aren't that great, you get a higher energy level. So for all these reasons, focusing on food composition, food quality is a really, really good idea. And we need to get that sorted and put it in place before we even start fine-tuning the macros. So for protein sources, it's a good idea for most, not necessarily all, but most of your protein sources to come from lean meats, lean dairy products, and or high quality vegan protein sources. For carbohydrates, veggies, real good idea. Fresh is better. Fruits, again, fresh is better. Whole grains, including whole grain breads, real great idea that most of your carbs come from those 3 sources. And for fat sources, if we're adding fats to meals, which sometimes we will be, especially early on in the plan, later on, if you do fat loss diet super, super strict and hard, you have to create such a big deficit that you end up getting so few fats in your diet that it just trace fats from the meats and the grains end up making up most of your fat. But for a lot of folks, their fat intake is going to be considerable, especially at the start of a diet. And if you're adding fat to your meals, it's probably best to add fats that are mostly monounsaturated fatty acids. They tend to be some of the best for health. And there's even some decent literature to say they promote fat loss while retaining muscle a bit better. And luckily, all kinds of really tasty sources of food have these fats in them. Olive oil, canola oil, nuts, nut butters, and avocados are really, really awesome, and they help support your performance. They help support your energy levels. They help support your health, and of course, your fat loss diet journey, and one that retains as much muscle as possible. So here's the deal. So far, we've got macros down. We know how many macros we're eating. We're still doing that through this process. And now, what you want to do is start tinkering with your diet to replace slice-o-pizza with healthy sources, like lean steak, brown rice, veggies, dab of avocado or something like that, just as a sample. Maybe not all the pizza, but if you eat like 5 slices of pizza a day, maybe take 4 out, do healthy and have 1 slice, something like that, at least as a start. More healthy food, less junk food, but still trying to hit the same macros as always. Okay, this actually might be a tough part of the diet, because when you replace your intake with healthy foods, you might realize like, holy crap, I can't even eat this much food. And if you can't eat that much food, just stop when you're full and put the rest of the food away. You may find that you automatically start having to eat way less food, because a lot of healthy food is just much harder to eat than junk food. Junk food is the easiest food in the world to eat. So just try to hit the same macros as normal, as you normally have been in the last 2 weeks before you started eating healthier. If you can't hit them, going under is totally fine. But don't go over, just hit them or go under. And then next week, when we do the next episode of the series, we'll talk about how to alter those macros to get the best possible results. We'll see you then.